Now, so here we go. This is the notation of a function. And what is it basically? This y, which is output, this is also called range, right? This f being the function, it can be anything, square, cube, or square plus 1, square plus 7, radical, anything, any function. This could be any function. And x is being, x being input means domain, as we all know, right? Okay, now further, input is domain and output is range. We all know about this, and we have discussed this example too before. Like, function is like a machine. You will be putting input means domain, function yahan pe ji machine, this is processing, right? And output means you are getting your neat clothes, clean clothes, right? And that would be your range, output result. Okay, now here I'm going to explain to you so many things through a mapping, right? Let us say we have two functions, A, having elements A and C, and B, having elements, let's say, B, D, and E. Now, I'll be calling this A as, this A would be my domain. All the elements of A would be domain, and all the elements of B would be codomain. Right? Here is the mapping between set A and B. This is A, this is B. Element of A, elements of A are A and C. Elements of B are B, D, and E. Now, if there is a mapping like this, which is F, this is a function between A and B, which goes from A to B, you can see, let us say that we all know by definition of functions that all the elements of set A should have a unique image in set B. Elements of A should have unique image of B means, image in B means, let us say A is connected with this element B and C is being connected with this element E. So I can say, okay, when F applied on A, I got B, and when F applied on C, I got E. Now, what have I come to know by doing this? This A and C, these are my domains. And what is my range? This B and E. B and E being my range, and A and C being my domain. Now, you can see that the codomain was complete set B, D, and E. This is D. B, D, and E. But the range has only two elements, which are B and E. Which tells us that those elements would be only range, which would be mapped with the elements of A. For example, here B is image of, this B is image of this A, and here this E is image of this C. And also we can say that this A is pre-image of B and this C is pre-image of E, right? I hope this is clear to you. You can take a screenshot and go through all the steps. If you didn't get anything, I'm here. You can ask me anytime. The same thing is being told to us in this slide. You can see function visualization. How are we going to visualize it? The same thing which I told you in the previous slide. Look at this. See, pre-image. This A, as this is being mapped with this element B. This B is range. This small a is your pre-image. Pre-image of whose? Whose pre-image? Of this B, right? And this small b is also your range. This whole set B is codomain. This whole set A is domain, right? All the elements of set A would be domain because they all have to be mapped with set B. But codomain, it's not necessary that all the elements of this codomain are images of elements of A, right? Look at this. So F, when applied on A, we got B. And how can you write down a function now? How can you represent it? A function F from A to B can be represented as this. Let us go to the next slide. So the same thing, domain, codomain, and range. Now you can understand it easily. some functions terminologies. Look at this. If f is a function from a to b, and f of a equals to b, which we have learned, where a was pre-image of b, whereas a belongs to capital A and small b belongs to capital B, then we can see that a is domain of f, b is codomain of f, small b is the image of a under f, and a is the pre-image of b under f. This is what we have discussed in that explanation slide. Note, in general, b may have more than one pre-image. What does it mean? It means, if you have this thing, a, c, let's say, and here we have only one element, let's say b or d as well. Okay, now let's say a is connected to b and c is also connected to b. Now b has more than one pre-images. B has pre-image a and b has also pre-image as c, which is possible, right? That is a possibility. But a should have only one image in set b. This is set p and this is set a. Similarly, c should have only one image in set b, which is the same. Let's go further. Finding value of a function, very important and very simple. In the first slide, if you remember, we discussed this example that y is equal to x square plus 1. We got the value of this y for x is equal to 0, if you remember. By putting this value of x equals to 0 in this equation, in this whole equation, we got y is equal to 1. So this basically, this y is equal to 1 is value of this function, right? For x is equal to 0, what is value of this function? Y is equal to 1. This is value of the function basically. We are going to do some examples. This is your question number 1 from exercise 1.1. I'm going to do two parts. I'm going to discuss two parts of it here, and the rest of the parts would be you're going to do rest of the parts as your assignment. Okay, look at this. Given that f of x is radical of x plus 4, this is your f of x. You have to find f of minus 2, which means x is going to be replaced with minus 2 where in this question. See, f of minus 2 here, f of minus 2 equals to radical of minus 2 plus 4, which became radical of 2. Similarly, next part, f of x square plus 4, you have to find value of this function f of x square plus 4 for f of minus 2. Okay, so now what you have to do is you have to find f of x square plus 4, right? For x square plus 4,